Hello again, everyone. I'm Terry Peterman, the Internet Electrician, and welcome to another video short on current topics at electrical-online.com and, of course, right here on YouTube. This will be just a short video, just as an update to my Movember.com campaign. As you may have seen in my previous video on this subject, I shaved off my signature goatee and went for growing the big stash here. The more garish and hideous, the better. It's all to raise funds and awareness for men's health issues. Now, you can donate at my Facebook page. I have a campaign going there, facebook.com/internetelectrician, as well as you can go to mobro.co/internetelectrician and help me raise funds there. I set a modest goal of $1,000, and that was saying that if all my subscribers were to donate just about 2 cents, we could easily raise $1,000. So let's get that campaign going a little harder, not going quite as well as I'd hoped. However, you may have just been aware of the Movember.com promotion and you might have already donated to somebody else's campaign, and that's okay. Just a donation is all we need to help raise funds and raise awareness for men's health issues. So in that previous video, I was showing you how I could light up an LED light bulb just using my mind. Now, of course, that's not the way it really works. And now I'm going to explain to you how that light bulb works and what that's all about. So this lamp here beside me now has that light bulb in it that I showed you. And what it is it's a special power fail light bulb. Now, I purchased this one in Costa Rica. It was from Licht, L-I-C-H-T. It's a company out of Germany. And I thought it was actually fascinating the way the technology behind this bulb, but now I did see somebody else has been producing one in North America as well. So, great idea. What it does is it works, functions normally as an LED light bulb when it's plugged in to a socket and turned on, and that also charges an internal battery inside of it. Now, what happens though if the power goes out, which I'll demonstrate here. As you can see here, I've got the lamp on, and I've just got a clock radio plugged in there with the time. I didn't bother setting the time, but just so you see, when the power goes out, that clock radio will stop and you can tell what happens to that lamp. So as you can see, the power in that outlet is gone. The clock radio quit flashing, but the lamp is still on. And as you see, when we restore the power, the light continues to operate. Now that light would function with the switch off and on just as normal without power at that outlet. However, it does have to be plugged in. So let me explain how that works. So let me just show you the bulb here. Shut off the lamp and unscrew the bulb from the socket. So it looks like an ordinary LED lamp or bulb, but there, like I said, there's a battery inside. So what happens when you got power? Turns on the LED lamp through the circuitry and the little internal driver. But when there's no power, then it relies on that battery to power the lamp itself or the bulb. But what it needs to see is a somewhat low resistance between the hot and the neutral, or the shell and the tip of the bulb. That's why it won't work in free air, because there's infinite resistance between those pieces, but it needs to have something there. So like I said, if you just provide any kind of resistance, it'll light itself up, shorting out between the centerpiece and the shell of the lamp. They also provide you with a socket like this that is just a shell, where the shell of the plastic holder here, the shell and the centerpiece, center pin, are all one piece of brass here, or copper. So when you screw that into that and it shorts it out, the light is on. So this is handy too. You can hang it somewhere. If the power is out, you can put this bulb wherever you'd like it just by the little hook on the holder. So if I just slowly short it out, not providing a whole bunch of pressure between my finger and my thumb, and then squeeze a little harder, it gets brighter, and slack off a little, it almost acts like a rheostat with the varying resistance between the shell and the center pin. So, great little lamp. Now, one of the drawbacks of it is that if it's plugged into like a multi-light fixture, like I tried it in my bathroom bar with four lights, well, you screw this in, it'll work great with the other three, four lights come on with the power. However, when you shut the switch off, then it sees the resistance provided by the other lamps in that bar and it turns on, so you can't shut it off that way. It needs to be in a single lamp holder needs to be plugged into a circuit, and the circuit that it's plugged into has to have other items, other accessories on that circuit that have been on or providing some kind of a resistance through a light bulb that isn't turned on or through a television that's plugged in. That's just enough resistance it'll see even without the power between the hot and neutral to make that lamp turn on. So there you have it. That's how I did that. Again, please go and donate to mobro.co/internet electrician. Let's raise some funds for men's health issues. And in a couple days here, I'm going to shave all this off and we can start over again. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Terry Peterman, the Internet Electrician.